billing system related articles in following site: www.pinepad.in/blog, or go to Java Technologies billing system. This is my site, pinepad.in. When you click blog, it will return all Java related technical articles. If you want to see only specific to billing system, go to Java Technology, click billing system. This will return only billing system related articles. Okay. Please follow me on medium.com. The reason I am saying is, if you follow me on medium.com, you will be getting all notification. You will be getting notification if I post any articles in pinepad.in or medium.com. This is the link which is from pinepad.in. This particular post contains all YouTube links which related to billing system. Okay, I will show that. See, billing system using Spring Boot, all YouTube video links updated here. This post contains all YouTube link that related to billing system. Okay. This information I have updated on YouTube description, on YouTube video description. Okay. Please check it out. Let's go into the video now. Welcome back, friends. In this video, I'm going to show how to create a username and a password, how to create a credential in a MySQL using MySQL Workbench tool. Okay. Now I'm going to remove the billing database and the billing username from the MySQL. I'm going to remove this drop schema. Remove the billing. Then I want to remove the username. Go to the administrator, click users, there is a billing username, right? I'll going to remove that. Delete. I removed everything now. Then connect to root. Connected MySQL using root. In the schema, I don't have billing. Also, when you check the user, there is no billing user. Now I want to create a billing user as a brand new billing user. Then I want to create a schema. Then I will going to restart my application. First, I'll going to create a schema. Okay. Database. Create schema. My database name is billing, right? Billing. This is the database name. Okay. Now I want to create a billing database. Apply. Finish. Now billing database creator. There is no tables now. Now I want to create a user. For that, click administration. Click user and the privileges. Click add account. Click the username you want to create. Now I want to create billing. Billing. Username as a billing. Then the login name, you need to pass the username. Then password. Whatever password I am using here. Billing $123. Copy that. Just paste it. Confirm password. Just paste it. That's it. It says medium length password. That's fine. Apply. See here, billing user is created now. Now I want to log in MySQL using this billing user. For that, close this. There is a MySQL connection, right? In this MySQL connection, when you open the workbench, I'll open a workbench. MySQL workbench. Once open the workbench, it will show the connection, available connection. This billing connection is invalid now. I removed that already. I delete this. I want to create a new billing connection. For that, click plus icon. Then give the connection name, billing connection. Then what is the username? We have created billing. Then password is billing 123 dollar dollar. Whenever login using billing, I want to set default schema as a billing schema. So I am saying here default schema billing. Now I am going to set test connection. Asking password. Password is billing. It says fails. I think I wrongly type. It says connection fail. Why? I'll copy this. Something. Test connection. Fail to connect with user billing. The reason is I'm setting a default schema as billing, right? As of now, that billing user does not have a privileges to use this billing schema. That's the reason it's failing, I think. I'll remove this. I'll go to set test connection. Now it's connected successfully. Because the reason is I used a billing schema, but the billing schema does not have a, the billing user does not have a permission to view this schema. That's the reason it's not able to connect. We need to log in as a root user. Then we need to provide billing database access to this billing user. Then only we can give your billing as a schema. Otherwise, we cannot give. As of now, I make this field as a blank. Okay. Now, when you say test connection, it successfully made the MySQL connection. Then click OK. When you open this billing connection, the schema section, we don't have any database. The reason is, as of now, that billing user does not have access to see all the database. We have to provide that access. Okay. Now we need to provide a DB access to billing user. For that, we need to log in as a root user. Okay. Close this billing connection. I'm going to opening the connection that logged in with root. Root password. Go to administration. Select user and the privileges. There is a billing user. Select that billing user. Go to schema privilege. Not a schema privilege. Administrative. Go to administrative roles. Click DBA. If you click DBA, you will get all the access to manipulate the tables in any database. Okay. Then click apply. Once you've done this, now billing user having the access to manipulate all the tables in the schemas. Okay. Now close this root connection. Again, I want to log in billing connection. Go to schema. See, now I'm able to see all the schemas. What we need? We need billing schema. Instead of billing schema, as of now, we don't have any tables. Okay, now I want to restart my application. Once to restart the application, our Spring Boot application will create all the table for us. Billing application run. It's creating and altering table, everything's happening now. Server started at 9091. When you look at the database, refresh it, see all the tables are created now. I hope you understand how to create a user in MySQL using MySQL Workbench. If you have any question, please comment me. Definitely, I'll going to answer. Okay. Actually, I was planning to create a video for a product and a product item, but I was thinking that people may struggle to set up billing system in the local environment, local environment. For that reason only, I have created this MySQL user creation video. In the next video, I'm going to create how to set up a billing system in your local environment using IntelliJ, Eclipse and STS. I have already written an article about this in pinepad.in. This article gives step-by-step instruction how to set up billing system in your local computer. Okay. Please read this article. Soon I will going to convert this article as a video tutorial. After that, I will going to explain about a product and a product item. I stop sharing my billing system Git repository. You cannot access my billing system Git repository. If you want to access my billing system latest code, you need to go to pinepad.in. You can see a download link. Click that link. This will land into this page. When you click download page, it will come to this page where you need to click download button to get latest code of billing system. Okay. Please share this video to your friends and colleagues. Also, please share this channel to people who is looking for real-time project in Spring Boot. I hope you enjoyed this video. Until then, bye-bye from Suresh. Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.